Kakao reorganized his army in Yanzhou and recruited many outstanding talents. Shen Yu, Cheng Yu, Gurjia, Man Chong, Lu Jin, and other talented people came to seek refuge with him, and Kakao thought highly of them. At this time, Kakao sent Ying Sha, the prefect of Taishan, back to his hometown to pick up his father Cao Song. When Cao Song passed by Xuzhou, Tao Jin entertained him warmly for 2 days and then sent his subordinate Zhang Kai to see him off, who knew that Zhang Kai killed Cao Song's family, robbed their property, and ran to Huainan. Ying Sha desperately escaped and went to join Yuan Sha. When Cao Cao found out, he cried very sadly. He said viciously, "Tao Jin allowed his men to kill my father. I must take revenge. I will lead the army to attack Xuzhou now. I am so angry." He led the army and marched towards Xuzhou under the banner of revenge. Everywhere they go, they kill innocent people. Ta Jin was a kind-hearted man. When he saw Cao Cao bringing an army to take revenge and killing people randomly, he cried and said to his subordinates, "Cao Cao's army is too powerful and we can't defeat it. I might as well tie myself up and give it to Cao Cao. Come and save the lives of the people in Xuzhou." Of course, the subordinates disagreed. Mi Zhu came up with an idea and said that he could seek help from Kong Rong, the governor of Baihai, and Tian Kai, the governor of Qingzhou. Mi Zhu saw Kong Rong and told what happened. While they were discussing, suddenly Guan Hai, a remnant of the Yellow Turban Army, brought tens of thousands of people to attack Xuzhou. Kong Rong felt that he could not defeat him, so he sent soldiers to find Liu Bei for help. Seeing that Kong Rong thought highly of him, Liu Bei immediately took Guan Yu, Zhang Fei, and 3,000 people to rescue Baihai. Guan Hai saw that Liu Bei and his men were few in number, so he didn't take them seriously. As a result, Guan Hai was hacked to death by Guan Yu within a few rounds. Liu Bei and the others took the opportunity to charge, and Kong Rong also led his men to fight out of the city. The Yellow Turban Army was defeated, and many people surrendered. Kong Rong took Liu Bei into the city and held a banquet to celebrate. Kong Rong invited Liu Bei to rescue Xuzhou. Liu Bei promised to go to Gongzhen to borrow some troops and horses and would come soon. Liu Bei borrowed 2,000 men and a powerful general named Zhao Yan, plus his original 3,000 men, to rescue Xuzhou. When they arrived at the gate of Xuzhou city, Zhang Fei led a charge and beat Yu Jin until he retreated repeatedly. When Liu Bei entered the city, Tao Jin hosted a banquet in his honor. Tao Jin was very happy to see that Liu Bei looked talented and spoke well. So he asked Mi Zhu to take out the leaders, seal, and transfer Xuzhou to Liu Bei. Liu Bei was startled and said, "What are you doing?" Tao Jin said, "You are a relative of the Han Dynasty royal family and should contribute to the Han Dynasty. I am old and have no ability, so I am willing to hand over Xuzhou to you." Liu Bei quickly stood up and saluted and said, "I am just a distant relative of the Han Dynasty royal family. I have no great achievements and I am not qualified. I am here to help this time. By saying this, do you think I have other thoughts? If I had such thoughts, God would not bless me." Ta Jin said, "I mean it." Liu Bei still refused to agree. Mi Zhu also said, It won't be too late to transfer Xuzhou to you after I defeat Cao Cao. So Liu Bei wrote a letter to persuade Cao Cao to retreat. After Cao Cao received the letter, he scolded Liu Bei. At this time, soldiers came to report that Lu Bu had attacked and occupied Yanzhou. It turned out that Lu Bu had escaped from Chang'an City. After coming out, he joined Yuan Shu, Yuan Sha, and Zhang Yan successively, but they didn't stay long. This time he followed Zhang Mao to attack Yanzhou. Cao Cao was shocked when he heard this, so he had to sell Liu Bei a benefit and hurriedly arranged for the army to retreat. Go and recapture Yanzhou. When the news of Cao Cao's retreat came, Ta Jin was very happy and invited everyone to drink together to celebrate. After drinking, Ta Jin still insisted on transferring Xuzhou to Liu Bei. Liu Bei said, "I am here to save Xuzhou."